If you are offering cargo as air freight, as a shipper, you play a vital role in helping to ensure the safety of the passengers and crew on board an aircraft. That's because some items you may wish to transport are classified as dangerous goods, which means that if they are not prepared and handled properly, they can pose risks to the health and safety of everyone on board. They can also pose a hazard to property, such as the aircraft itself, other cargo, baggage, airport equipment, and the environment. Sadly, there have been accidents where crews and passengers have been killed because dangerous goods were not correctly prepared for air transport by shippers, including one in 1996, when a DC-9 aircraft operated by the airline Valuejet crashed into the Everglades swamps shortly after takeoff. All 110 people on board were killed. There have been other fatal accidents, including one involving a Boeing 747 freighter aircraft in Dubai in September 2010. A severe fire developed on the main cargo deck of the aircraft to such an extent that the crew lost control and both were killed in the subsequent crash. The cause of the fire is not known for sure, but large quantities of lithium batteries were being carried, many of which were subsequently determined to have been improperly prepared for transport by the shipper. The term dangerous goods may conjure up all kinds of images, such as bombs, infectious substances, and radioactive material. However, many are items which are used routinely every day without concern, but which in transport pose a hazard, and so they need to be prepared in accordance with very stringent requirements prescribed by the International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO, and the International Air Transport Association, IATA. For example, cleaning solvents may pose little hazard on the ground, but in the air, the fumes could seriously affect passengers and, more importantly, the crew members. Some dangerous goods are so dangerous they may not be allowed for carriage at all. Dangerous goods are classified based on their hazard and are categorised into 9 groups called classes, some of which are subdivided into divisions. So, dangerous goods will always fall under one of these classes or divisions, and some dangerous goods may have one or even 2 additional or subsidiary hazards. Let's take a look at the 9 classes and some examples. Class 1 is for explosives. Not surprisingly, most explosives are not allowed to be shipped by air, but there are some which are allowed on cargo aircraft only, and others, in Division 1.4S, such as ammunition, that pose a very low risk and are allowed on passenger aircraft. Class 2 is for gas. There are 3 types of gas in this class: flammable gas, such as aerosols or propane; non-flammable, non-toxic gas, such as oxygen; and toxic gas, such as carbon monoxide. Class 3 is for flammable liquids, such as paint and petrol or gasoline. Class 4 is for flammable solids, such as matches or firelighters; substances that can combust spontaneously, such as phosphorus; and others that give off flammable gas when they get wet, such as sodium. Class 5 is for oxidizers, such as bleach, and organic peroxides, such as car repair kits. Class 6 is for toxic or poisonous materials, such as rat poison, and also infectious substances, such as blood containing disease. Class 7 is for radioactive materials, such as those used in medicine to treat cancer. Radioactive material is shipped extensively in air transport because if it doesn't move quickly, it is useless on arrival, so it is vital we do all that we can to make sure that we don't delay its transport, providing, of course, it complies with the regulations. Class 8 is for corrosives. These can either burn our skin, such as various acids, or weaken the structure of the aircraft, for example, mercury. Class 9 is for miscellaneous dangerous goods. These are articles and substances which pose a hazard but do not fit under the other 8 classes. An example of this is dry ice, which is the gas, carbon dioxide, in solid form. Carbon dioxide can suffocate in confined spaces, such as the hold of an aircraft, so it is vital loading staff know when it is to be loaded or unloaded from an aircraft. Lithium batteries are also in Class 9. If dangerous goods comply with the requirements, it is extremely unlikely that any problems will arise. You may be unaware of the dangers presented by items you wish to transport, but it is your responsibility as the shipper to determine whether the items meet the criteria of dangerous goods, and if so, that they meet all of the applicable requirements, such as packing, marking, labelling, and documentation. The original manufacturer should know whether items they produce are dangerous goods, so if you are in any doubt, contact them for advice. If you can obtain a Material Safety Data Sheet, or MSDS, check Section 14. If a UN number is quoted, you know the substance in question is dangerous goods. There are some other indications that will help you, such as the hazard warning labels we looked at earlier, any four-digit number prefixed with the letters UN, and these Globally Harmonised System, or GHS, labels. Qatar legislation requires that before anyone ships dangerous goods by air, they receive dangerous goods training commensurate with their responsibilities. It is also an offence for anyone to cause dangerous goods to be delivered for transport by air, for example via your freight agent, when they do not comply with the requirements of ICAO and IATA. Therefore, it is essential for you as a shipper to establish whether you are shipping dangerous goods, and if you are, you ensure they are packed, marked, labelled and documented correctly. This will ensure you comply with the legislation and, more importantly, you do not put an aircraft and everyone on it in danger. Thank you for listening.